And good morning. Pag-usapan natin ngayon is earning 20% sa mangisda.org. What is this? Why is this the topic for today? It's because kahapon we just posted in mangisda.org na nag-harvest na sa mangisda.org, and so many messages came in and asking about it. So why not talk about it again? For those na hindi pa alam ito, sa mga bago kong followers, sa mga hindi pa alam what mangisda.org is, so this is the best time to talk to you about this. Sa mga alam na po, don't worry, we have stock market topic after. We'll talk about the market. I'm getting excited for tomorrow, so I'm expecting, kasi bukas pa ang pinakamagandang oras sa market, at before the end of the market, the last market day, yan po yung pinakamaganda ipasok. So we're gonna be doing bargain hunting for tomorrow, and yun pong paghahandaan natin. But anyways, for today, yan, mangisda.org muna. Hindi, ngayon pala, right? So ngayon pala yung last day. So expect sa Billionaires Club, we're gonna be magpo-post po ako ng magandang pasukin before the end of the market para po bargain hunting for next year. We're expecting a green for today. Friday na pala ngayon, right? So, yeah. Okay, mangisda.org. If you sa mga hindi pa alam what mangisda.org is, we have a Facebook page, mangisda.org. Just search for it for mangisda.org, and you should be able to see this page. Andito po ang pinakamaraming information about it, even the introduction video, so you'll understand more about the business. But before we do that, let me just go to the to the slide really quick. And so present ko po sa inyo yung slide to present mangisda.org properly. Mas maganda kasi ma-explain ko po sa inyo, di ba? So I'm just waiting for the slideshow to start. Yun, may questions dito. Morning, Mads. Nanetmil, good morning, Sir Lloyd. Happy holidays, Ram. Details, Sir Lloyd. Yes, we will talk about the details for today. Jake Paul, good morning, Sir Lloyd. And to your daughter, Leica, how is MWC and retime? Thank you for Sir Lloyd in advance. Happy New Year. So I told you before, di ba? Nung unang green pa lang ni MWC, we're expecting MWC to go up, right? And then all you need to do is time it na lang, right? So we'll check if pwede ba i-retime yan, pero huwag po kayo maingat if hindi nyo po nahuli yan. Anyways, we'll talk about mangisda.org first. So this is the slide that I prepared for today, an introduction to mangisda.org. So what is mangisda.org? We are the finance arm of Mangisda ng Biasong Lopezaina, LGS Lopezaina, Northern Mindanao Association, a registered association whose aim is to provide financial access to the lesser fortunate fisher folk of Mindanao through crowdfunding, right? Crowdfunding po itong website nito, specifically for the fisher folk in Lopezaina who operates fish cage farming. So this is the permit of the organization. So for legitimacy sake, yan po is importante po if nahinahanap ninyo, if you're investing in a cooperative or in an association, so if you avail of their services, so this is what you look for. So this is from the DOLE, the association is workers association po, right? So ito po yung and then there's the seal there, you can see it slightly, pero hindi po makikita kasi yung seal sa scan niya. So but anyways, the seal is there, and then there's the signature of the provincial head, right? So now and ask me, sir, investments ito diba dapat kay SEC, right? That's true, dapat kung investment siya, but here the association is allowed by the government to sell fishes, right, and to offer services. So pwede po silang magbenta ng services and their products for funding purposes. So ang ginawa po ni mangisda.org, since we're not selling shares, we're selling pre-selling fishes basically and the services. So hindi po kailangan ng SEC permit, right? So the organization again is allowed to sell the fishes and provide services for funding. So that is what the organization is doing lang, right? So here, what is crowdfunding, just to let you understand, I'll explain to you more what mangisda.org is doing, okay? What is crowdfunding muna? Crowdfunding is the practice of funding a project or venture by raising small amounts of money from a large number of people, typically via internet. So by internet po tayo. Diba dati to gather funds, you have to either loan from the bank, look for investors manually and present your projects. Yun po ang usual, diba? May stock market para sa mga malalaking companies, so they go IPO, they offer it to the public, diba? And now that the internet world is booming, right? Crowdfunding has already been starting. Meron pa po ibang mga crowdfunding na sikat dito sa Pilipinas, which is farmon.ph. May seed in din po. I presented to you that, what they call this, I presented it to you on the last episode, I believe so, right? Yung top 5 investments for your 13th month pay, andun po sila, right? So, crowdfunding is already a thing of the now. It's already here now because of the internet, di ba? So, konting ingat lang sa crowdfunding. You have to do your due diligence first before investing in them. Okay? Meron ng ganito dati. Dito, even here in Cebu, may mga crowdfunding na ano din. May mga crowdfunding din ng mga activities. So, it's up to you to do your due diligence and study about the business or the organization or what you call this, ano ba yung pinapasukan ninyo ng crowdfunding that you're willing to invest in, right? So yes, it's typically via internet. So here, yung crowdfunding kasi, instead na lumapit tayo sa isang tao na may pera and present the project so we'll invest, right? So what crowdfunding does is, instead sa isang tao lang, maraming tao po ang lalapitan ng crowdfunding kasi internet is a very good way to network, to spread your network. So, at least here, so marami pong tao tayo na representan and then people can now chip in para mas maliit yung risks involved sa isang investor, di ba? And it's typically done via internet. Right, crowdfunding in mangisda.org. So, this is how crowdfunding works in mangisda.org. I hope everything is well. Halang ha, kasi yung okay lang ba yung audio? Alright, so yan, let me check out the comments first before we continue. Vine, good morning. Jake Paul, good morning. Charlotte Johnson, may buntag by Lloyd. Good morning. Si Charlotte Johnson, may buntag. Alright, so crowdfunding, here is how crowdfunding in mangisda.org works. The biggest problem of fishermen in Mindanao kasi when it comes to sea cage farming is access to funds. Kasi ang isang fish cage to operate costs around 650,000 pesos. 600 to 700,000 pesos po. Ang pinakamalaking gastos po niyan is creating the cage. Isa. Number two is to get the fishes, yung habang maliit pa sila. So that's another big chunk of the production. And then lastly, yung feeds po. You are gonna be feeding the bangus. Bangus po yung atin. You're gonna be feeding the bangus for the next 5 months. And that's 15,000, roughly around 15,000 bangus per cage. So that's very big. So a very big bulk of the investment is in the feeds, right? So, yun po, because it's 650,000, nahihirapan po ang mga mangingisda to fund that. Actually, yung mga mangingisda dyan is, has been provided ba, provided po sila ng government, ng fish cage before, right? The fish cage here is a project by the government. They donate po ito sa mga mangingisda dyan because the area is a mariculture park, later on about that, but basically there were 200 cages operating there before kasi linibre po ng government yan, but because of the cost of the project ngayon po is around 60 na lang na cages ang operating, 60 cages lang operating because hindi po nasusustain ng mga mahihirap. Ang 60 cages na operate lang yan is yung mga mayayaman na lang, right? Kasi hindi kaya ng mga mahirap. It's either to get the 650,000, mag-loan po sila sa banko, which is unlikely na ma-approve sila kasi wala po silang pang collateral. Ang option po nila is lumapit sa mga may pera. Yan yung mga may pera, yun yung nag-ooperate ng ibang cage. So, ang laki po ng patong, tapos nagpapatong pa sila sa feeds, etc. Sila pa bumibili ng isda, tapos napakamura nila binibili yung isda. So, ang ending, wala po nakakuha sa mga isda. Kaya po, it's not feasible for the small players, kaya natigil po sila. So, now, we're creating the solution para po sa mga maliliit na players na fishermen, para talaga sa intended. Kasi yung fish cage talaga na project ng government was really intended for the poor ones. Pero ang mga mayayaman lang ang nakakapag-take advantage because walang pang fund ang mga mahihirap na mga isda natin. Diba? So, yan. The biggest problem of the fishermen in Mindanao when it comes to sea cage farming is access to funds. A full cycle of harvest costs a big amount, which a typical fisherman do not have. So mangisda.org organized these cages. So gumawa po kami ng association ng mga itong mga mangisda na walang pera, needs funding, right? And presented the project to those who are willing to avail of the service of the association. We pre-sell the bangus and offer the manage the growth and sale of them, right? And share the profits afterwards. So ang ginagawa po ng mangisda.org is we procured the bangus and then kami na po bahala bumili ng feeds and pinipre-sell po namin sa inyo. So we sell it to you in advance. Okay? So and then kami na po ang magma-manage and kami na po ang magbebenta para sa inyo. Then after that, yung kita sinishare po ng mga fishermen tsaka nung nagbili yung nag-pre-sell, you're basically nag-invest, you're nag-avail ng services ng mangisda.org. So the crowdfunder will be choosing the projects he or she wants to participate in whenever an opportunity is open. So opportunities can be found in the website mangisda.org. Meron po tayong walkthrough video so you understand how to navigate through the website, but we won't be talking about that here. Okay, so this is how crowdfunding works in mangisda.org. So the business, I want to present to you the business. The location is in Lopez Sina, Biasong, Lopez Sina. I'll show you the location later. This is a BFAR, Bureau of Fisheries and Aquatic Resources. Part po yan ng Department of Agriculture. BFAR accredited business location. And then we have a low maintenance product. Very low maintenance po. Kasi madali lang po buhayin ang bangus. All you need to do is feed them, and make sure they are, the location is healthy, hindi po overcrowded ng isda ang lugar. And it's very easy to maintain. Once you have the cage and then you have the fish inside, all you need to do every day is just feed them. And yun na yun, right? Hindi kailangan paliguan, hindi kailangan palinisan, etc. So it's very low maintenance, very easy to maintain. It's managed by the 2012 BFAR director. This is Mr. Desi Bazar. His expertise is into fish cage farming. He's my dad. Siguro nagmana ako kay dad. Dad is still ongoing. Advocate of fish cage farming. Siya po ang pinapadala ni BFAR to provinces and tinuturuan po yung mga mangingisda natin ng mga Pilipino paano po ang fish cage farming, right? This is the modern way of being a fisherman, and that's my dad's expertise, and tinuturo po yan sa mga Pinoy. Okay, and then my dad is managing the association there. Okay, so this is the business location. It's in Lopesina. This is called Lopesina Mariculture Park. It's a BFAR accredited business location. So ito po yung aerial view niya. This is from Google Earth on April 2019, so that you will know as of April 2019, ito po yung makikita ninyo na fish cages. I mean, yung aerial view, so that you can really see it there, right? Search for it in Google Earth. So for legitimacy, para makita nyo na may cages talaga, right? This is look for Biasong, Lopesina, Misamis Occidental, and then you can see these tiny squares on the sa dagat po yan, and then andyan po yung mga fish cages. So this is the deep part of the sa dagat yan, right? And ayan, this is a further view. Makikita nyo po ang mga cage talaga dito, right? So mas marami po yan, right? So this is much further view. Okay, so a little, pakita ko po sa inyo how feasible the location is. If you go to the webs, to the Facebook page, right? Search for mangisda.org. Meron po ditong video na nakapin. I'll just play it for one moment, okay? Even the first part lang. So I want to show you how feasible the place is. So So this is the aerial view of the cages, right? We use the drone for this, but nakikita niyo po yung dagat. Parang pinlansya. So wala pong alon ang dagat doon. That's why it's very feasible for fish cage, kasi yung ang kalaban kasi ng fish cage, yung malalaking alon or maalon, nasisira yung mga cage, right? So here, kita niyo po, walang alon. I'll continue the video. Gaano po kaganda ang location. So here, so eto may mga bangka kayo nakikita. Maliliit na bangka pang isang tao. Mas malaki pa ang alon ang ginagawa ng isang maliit na bangka kaysa sa alon sa area. This is how feasible the area is, kaya po napakaganda ng fish cage doon. And hindi po it's very safe from calamities. Pag nagbabagyo po diyan po nagkakaalon. Pag nagkabagyo. So pero pag nagkaalon man, hindi naman parehas sa mga dagat natin dito na ang lalaki ng mga alon. Dito po is yung location kasi is on a cove, so protected po siya ng landmass. Kaya hindi po nakakapasok yung malalaking alon. So I want you to watch this video so that you'll understand the business more. Kagandahan po ng mangisda.org, unlike other I'm not bad mouthing other crowdfunding projects, but it's very visible. All right, our forte is into in social media. Ako po, makikita niyo po ako sa social media, and I manage the marketing and the finance of mangisda.org. I make sure that this is visible for everyone. All the updates, and kaka-harvest lang po namin kahapon. I'll show you the harvest video. But mayroon, makikita niyo po lahat dito. So this is the harvest video of yesterday. This was done yesterday, and here are the photos of the fishermen there enjoying the bounty. So yun po yung first harvest kahapon. So the fishermen were very happy, even the investors were happy na nakikita nila ito. May mga naligaw pang mga crabs. But yeah, this was the first harvest, a very successful harvest for everyone. And dito po ang mga updates, so whenever a new project is up, you can get updates here. There are videos here na to show you the updates. Nagkakaroon po ng projects yung BFAR dyan, Department of Agriculture, sa Mariculture Park natin, and I make sure that this is visible for everyone. So this is one of the beauty of mangisda.org, it's the visibility. Anyways, let's continue. Alright, so what is a mariculture park? Ano ba yung mariculture park na ririnig nyo sa akin? A mariculture park is similar in concept with establishments of an industrial state. So, siguro, here in Cebu, we have these, we have business parks. Para siyang, kung sa Manila pa, isang city na pang negosyo talaga. For example, Makati, that's a business, that's a business district, that's a business city, di ba? Or may district sa Makati na pang negosyo talaga. So here naman, parang ganun rin. Parang sa land din ng mga business parks. Pero dito sa dagat, right? Sa dagat po ito, right? So, similar with the establishment of an industrial state in land areas where raw lands are made accessible by putting up the basic infrastructure such as road, power, water, communications, and other basic facilities to spare the interested entrepreneurs of the high cost of land acquisition and preparation. So instead na ang mga businessmen bibili pa ng lupa, magde-develop pa ng lugar, dine-develop ito ng maybe isa developer or ng LGU or the government develops an area and then puts up infrastructure, and then the businessmen just ang sa kanila na lang magrenta na lang ng lugar, so mas madali na lang, right? So ganun po, right? So para hindi na po gumastos ng malaki for land acquisition and preparation. Instead, it only has to pay for annual lease, which amount is only fraction of what it would have cost to acquire and develop raw lands for its use. If such infrastructure can be established on land for entrepreneurs and large companies, then there is even more reason to provide similar infrastructure for poor, small fisheries, fishers, and other investors. So here, this is the mariculture park. Dinevelop po ito ng government so that the fishermen can go there and start their business of fish cage, right? Basically, kahit ikaw po, kung gusto mo po magkaroon ng fish cage, pwede po kayong pumunta doon, register with the government na pwede po ba ako magtayo ng fish cage dito, and then build your own fish cage, right? and then start the business there. So magbabayad lang kayo. As of the moment, for yung bayad ng association with the LGU is around 2,500 a year, right? So yan po yung renta, bale, to get a spot for mariculture, for to get a fish cage. So pwede po kayo magsimula actually ng inyo doon. If you wanna ask me how, kung gusto nyo magsarili and kayo talaga you wanna go through the hassle, so you can do that. Just send us a message, we'll help you. We can link you with the association. The association is helping anyone who wants to start their own. Okay? And then here's the source of this. Makikita nyo po dyan yung mga source ng links dyan, so that you will know about this. Makikita nyo po dyan yung mariculture natin sa andyan po sa BFAR na website. Makikita nyo po yung location natin dyan. Okay, so qualifications for a mariculture park. Paano po ba ma-qualify ang isang lugar to become a mariculture park by Department of Agriculture, right? It should be a weather-friendly location to protect cages from harsh weathers. And you saw earlier in the video how friendly the waters is in the location, right? Nakita nyo po, if you have been to Taal Lake, di ba nakita nyo po ang daming fish cage doon sa Taal Lake? That's because wala pong waves doon, wala pong alon doon, kaya maganda po mag-fish cage. And it is in a similar situation there, right? So makita nyo po gaano ka peaceful yung dagat doon. Water salinity must be optimal for fish farming. That's the second qualification, and that's already been checked by BFAR. So to protect the capital, dapat maganda yung tubig. And then non-disruptive, right? The park should not be disruptive of the present livelihood culture of the location. For example, dito sa Cebu, maraming beaches, right? So may beach, tapos may fish farm sa unahan. I mean, may mariculture park sa unahan. So it's very disruptive for the current livelihood, which is tourism sa Cebu. So, kaya hindi po pwede sa Cebu ang fish farm kasi tourism po ang livelihood dito. So it has to be considered also, okay? So yan. So the product, low maintenance product, which is the bangus. Napaka low maintenance po ng bangus. Sobrang dali lang po buhayin. That's why it's called the national fish, because it's easy to farm. All you need to do is feed them, and then yung location, basta may maganda lang location. Right, why bangus? This source po nito. This is the link for the source. You can check it out and pause the video later on, and if you wanna see more about bangus. Bakit maganda ang bangus cultivation in the Philippines, right? Bangus is easy to sell and can be exported. Yan, very good po. We are already actually the organization is already starting to create a community for women, kasi yung mga fishermen lalaki karamihan, yung mga babae walang ginagawa. So yung mga babae, we're organizing for the women in the community para gumawa po ng factory, parang production area for boneless bangus, right? So it's easy to sell and can be exported. It's very low maintenance, easy to breed, farm, and has the fastest growth rate, keeping costs at minimal. If you ask bakit bangus lang, kasi po ang bangus ang pinaka mabilis tumubo sa mga isda, kaya maganda po siya i-farm. So konti lang ang feeds na nagagastos, and then it's already at its optimal size. So that's why bangus is the most feasible product for this. Right, so ito yung management. Mr. Desi Bazar is the 2012 BFAR National Director. This is his expertise. He's my dad, to be, what do you call this? To be transparent with you, he's my dad. Right, ganito po kasi yan. We already have the existing business na fish cage farming. Meron na po kami doon. I told you before, meron pong natitira na mga operating na fish cage. We are one of them. And then, yun nga, gusto ng dad ko na, gusto namin na yung real purpose of fish cage farming, which is for the poor, ma-realize talaga. And we wanted to expand it to really, even to for people na walang panggastos. But that was the biggest problem there. And ito, here I am, whose expertise is into investments, and we have the network. That's why I decided to take up this project, and so far it's very successful. Kami lang alone as a family, the business is doing well, and we really want to share it to everyone, right? That's why we created mangisda.org. Okay, What is in it for investors, especially ikaw? Are you interested in investing in mayisda.org? Projected of 10% to 20% annual returns. So 10 to 20% depending po yan sa result ng what do you call this? Sa result ng harvest, right? Annual returns depending on the status of the harvest with only 1 year holding period. Ito po yung isa sa pinakamaganda dyan. It's really hard to look for an investment that will give you 10 to 20%. Right? 10% alone, it's really hard to look for that already. Anything higher than that is really hard. Yung legitimate, mahirap po maghanap dyan. Meron po nagbibigay dyan ng 30% a month, but kayo na po bahala dyan. Right? Here, the promise po, as long as maganda ang harvest, we're gonna be giving 10 to 20% annual returns. Right? Depending on the status of the harvest with only 1 year holding period. 1 year lang po holding period. MP2 program, I always present to you MP2 program. MP2 program, mas lesser naman ang risk niya because it's handled by the government. So nga lang, 7 to 8%. That's already very good. 7 to 8% is already very good. Kaso nga lang, 5 years ang holding period niya. Here, it's a much shorter term and much bigger return. Right? 10 to 20% po ang makukuha ninyo. Plus, there is loyalty rewards. As of the moment, di ba may existing na tayong mga participants for the cages, right? If you, for example, 1 year lang kasi yung holding period, if you decide after 1 year, hindi nyo pa kailangan ng pera, and you want to re-roll it for the next waves, meron pong loyalty rewards which is standing right now at 2%. So if ever this yield, this year's yield is at 20%, and then for next year, another 20%, and may loyalty bonus ka kasi kinontinue for last year. If you get, if the yield is 20%, then there is additional 2%, so you get 22%. So, may loyalty rewards po tayo. So, may plus po yan, may patong po ang tubo ninyo. Right? And then, visibility of the projects. Very important for me when it comes to investing, I wanna know how my investment is going, and that is my task for you guys. Visibility for the projects through Facebook updates. Again, you can please go to search for mangisda.org in Facebook, like it para ma-updated po kayo, right? So how hot mangisda.org is right now, this December nag-open po tayo ng cage, isang cage po which is 650,000 at 8 a.m. In just 2 hours na puno na po kaagad. In just 2 hours na puno na po ang investment. So we were able to build 650,000 pesos in just 2 hours. Kaya po mainit po ito. Next project will be on January, dalawang cage ang i-open. So I hope you study it now habang maaga pa. Study more about it. Visit the website. If you want to visit the site, if nasa Mindanao po kayo, just go to Biasong Lupesaina and look at the projects there. You can do that. But you don't have to do that because andyan po, updated po yan lahat. We post videos, kinakamusta po namin. Ako po yan yung kalbo sa likod. Right? Ako po yan, kinakamusta ko po every now and then a project for you guys. And I make beautiful updates for you as much as possible para makita nyo po yung project. Right? The cage are existing already. Okay, let's continue with the slides. Right? So again, visibility is one of your advantage. So we will make sure you see what the problem, kung may problema man. Right? Nagkabagyo tayo the past few days, di ba? This week. Eh, hindi naman naapektahan doon. So there was no problem. And nakapag-harvest pa nga tayo just yesterday. Mangisda.org's feasibility, ito, very beautiful. Feasibility in Lopesana Mariculture Park has always been year on year. Right? I tell you, we already have a business on our own there. Kami po, may sarili po kaming cages doon. Aside from mangisda.org already. And it's been giving us good bounty year on year. And that's why we are very confident that when you open the business to investors for expansion, we can deliver as we have always been with existing investors because we already have our own projects there. It's been doing us good, right? How do we manage risk for investors? Protection. This is very important. If ako po investor, pag nagka-problema po dyan, kasi yung calamities, yes, nagkabagyo last week, nalibre ang na-spare yung lugar. But what if tumama talaga at magka-problema? It can happen, di ba? The biggest typhoon, Yolanda, wala naman nangyari doon. Waves, but nothing big of a problem. So it was still okay even during Yolanda. How do we manage risks for investor protection. This is for you. As part of our organization's promise to investors, we will lower risk as much as possible. But since there will be times that it will be inevitable, like natural calamities, we will ensure that your money will not be lost, right? Meron po kaming spare na funding just in case magka-problema itong batch na ito, right? Hindi po mawawala ang investment nyo. What we're gonna do is the funds that you have there, since you already have emergency funds, we are gonna be using that to create another wave para po yung pera nyo doon hindi mawala. So mangyayari po niyan, magkakaroon lang po ng delay, but it's your money is gonna be forwarded to the next batch right away so that funds can still roll. Okay? Though no gains will be provided for the lost harvest, your money will still be there and it will be forwarded to the next batch, and then dun po tayo sa next batch magkakaroon ng returns. This is the biggest risk an investor will shoulder under us. Yun po yung pinakamalaking risk ninyo to shoulder us. Yung gains lang po mawawala, but the money will not be lost. We have existing funds already. This is why I am here. That's because I'm helping the organization with finances and how to manage risk. Problema po kasi sa mga mangisda, especially, you know, typical Pinoy, is they don't know how to manage funds. And that is why I am here with them right now. So I help them with risk management. Just in case something happens, we already have emergency funds ready for this instance. So rest assured, I will be with you along the way with the journey natin sa investments. Alright, so, wait. Is that all? How do you manage risk? Wala eh. Yeah, so that was it for the slide for mangisda.org. It's 906 times check. Do you have any question about mangisda.org? Please let me know so that we can discuss it now. If ever hindi na po natin ma-discuss, mangisda.org is a running page in Facebook, so you can always send a message there and then we will respond to you every time, right? Good morning, Vine, Joanne Rulampagos, good morning, Charlotte Mangbuntag, Rebecca Tangan, good morning, Sir Lloyd, happy new year. Yung crowdfunding po ba may IRR sa SEC? It depends po. If ever po an organization sells shares, so that will require registration and permits from SEC. But the organization we have with mangisda.org, ang ginagawa po natin is we are allowed, an organization is allowed to sell, hindi po shares ang binibenta natin, but isda po. So we are allowed to pre-sell the fishes to you. Yan po yung ginagawa natin, pre-sell po natin sa inyo, so you own the fish and then we help you sell it and then share profits thereafter. But with this, you don't need any SEC regulations, but we are regulated by the government still nonetheless, but as an organization tayo po, so we're allowed to sell the fishes, so no need for SEC registration. Charlotte Johnson, mangisda, more power. Thank you so much, Charlotte. So we already have existing investors. Rebecca Tangen, need po ba mag-deposit ngayon to reserve a slot? Very good question. If you open, let me open the website, okay? So mangisda.org. Alright, so this is how mangisda.org looks like. Okay, so the initial page po is login page na po tayo. So when you get into the website, ito po yung makikita ninyo, mangisda.org. May video dyan about us. So information is also available in the website. So you, to join, you register first and then you can log in. So once you log in, let me sign in. This is what you are gonna see, right? So bigay ko na po sa inyo, or pakita ko na po sa inyo. Right, so you have a dashboard and then you have projects. I don't know why it's not loading right now. Pero para po itong call financial. So you have your dashboard. Dito nyo po, bagal yung website. So kasi nag-update kami ngayon, we're preparing the website for for harvesting na kasi, for withdrawal. So here is the dashboard. So I have an available balance of 13,000 pesos. You can add funds anytime, right? So may ano po dyan, may instructions po how to add funds and you can withdraw funds. May instructions din po dyan how to withdraw funds. Okay, so since I have 13,000 here, I can always withdraw it anytime, So, pwede po yan. And then, there are projects here. Dito nyo po makikita yung current na wave. So, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 waves ongoing. So, if ever may mag-open po dito na wave 6, for example, this January, we're gonna be opening 2 waves. So, that's gonna be wave 6 and wave 7. Itim po yung box na yan if ever that lot is still available. And if there is still available, may button po dito na invest and reserve. So, invest, as long as your funds allow it, you can get as many cages as you want. For example, may 65,000 ka. Since a unit costs around 6,500, if you have 65,000, then you can get 10 right away. Kung may funds kayo available. Kung wala po kayong funds available, pwede po kayong mag-reserve. And then, tatlo lang po ang pwedeng i-reserve ninyo kung wala po pong funds available. So, it's best if you fund it first para po when the wave opens, you can get as many as you want already. Okay? Kasi pag wala pong funds, to be fair with those na legitimate talaga na magpapasok ng pera, tatlo lang po ang pwede natin reserve. Kasi reserve lang po yan, wala pa po yung pera. What if nireserve mo marami, hindi ka pala kukuha? Unfair naman po doon sa mga kukuha talaga. So we only limit reservations to 3 units po, right? So what we did is, diba 650,000 ang per cage na operation, we broke it down to 100 units. So per unit only cost 6,500. So advantage for you is, even if maliit ka pa lang na investor, maliit lang ang pera ko, on 13th month ko, ito lang, or ito lang kaya ko by January, so you can already start with 6,500. Even yung pamangkin ko, nag-open na ng account, kasi yung nakuha niya na mga pamas ko, last December, invest niya daw dito. So even the small guys, right, yung mga high school pa lang yun ako, yung pamangkin ko, so he can already invest in here. Right? So, pwede po yan. So, as low as 6,500. That's the beauty of it. And then, it's up to you how many you want to invest. So, makikita nyo po dito, para pong call financial yan. And then, there is transaction history. And then, you can contact support. It directs you to our Facebook page. And then, hindi po nyo po nakikita dito. But, dito po sa dashboard, kung may investments po dito, status, if ever finished na, you can, what you do is, you can, dito po sa status, itong bumibilog na ito. What you can do is click on if ever tapos na yung isang wave, yung isang nag-mature na po yung bilhin niyo isda, and pwede niyo na pong kunin yung pera. Makikita niyo po dito, and then once you click on claim, yung pera po diyan mapupunta po sa available balance niyo. What if meron akong kailangan i-claim na yon na 10,000 pesos, yung 10,000 madadagdag dito, so magiging 23,000 yan. And then I can always withdraw funds. Instruction for withdrawing funds. So whatever your available balance is, pwede niyo po i-withdraw anytime. Okay? So we have a website to automate everything so that madali lang po para sa isang if you want to participate, it's convenient for you. Right, it's through the website. Okay, so we have a dedicated support for this, so that whenever you send us a message, whenever may comment kayo sa page, may sasagot po sa inyo. Right, we make that available for you. Pero office hours lang po. So to answer Rebecca Tangan, need na po ba mag-deposit ngayon to reserve a slot? I recommend yes, you can deposit now to prepare for January para mauna po kayo. Francis Fahilan, good Friday morning, Sir Lloyd. Good morning po. Johan is here watching. Mads, Sir Lloyd, okay na ba pasukin sa ISM Starbucks? I'm still holding my Starbucks. I'm still invested in Starbucks. Si ISM, you know, I'm still an investor kay ISM. Sabi ko sa inyo, bilhin na yun habang mura pa eh. Right, Joy Pimentel, congratulations. Thank you so much, Joy. Chris Nas, bakit sa FB po kayo naka-live, sir? Ngayon po, nag-FB po ako ng live because I'm trying to monetize my Facebook page. And as I wanna feature this in the future, kasi pwede na po yung kumita sa Facebook, di ba? Alam niyo po dati sa YouTube kumikita ng pera, and then you can also earn now in Facebook. So I wanna make my Facebook earn also. So kaya dito po ako nagla-live for the meantime. R. Lauren Mendoza, good morning. Joan Cornejo, good morning, sir. Risk percentage po. Ang pinaka-risk lang po natin talaga is ever magka-problema ang ano doon eh. Ang magka-problema ang mga isda doon. But so far, wala naman po problema. Us as operators, we haven't experienced any problems there. Nagkaka-problema man lang because before, we purchased the little fishes in the Dipolog pa, even featured that in the video. And stress factor lang po sa pag-transport ng isda papunta sa cages. Yun po ang pinaka-malaking risk natin. But biggest way to mitigate that is we already have a solution for it po. You should be able to see the solution in this video right here. So please watch this video. Basically, it's in the video. We already si BFAR, Department of Agriculture, itong video na po na ito, itong update, November update po ito. So, please watch this video. Si Bureau of Agriculture, sila BFAR, right? Makikita niyo po dyan. Magdo-donate po sila ng 1 million to the organization. So, they're donating a 1 million worth of facility sa organization natin. That's the government supporting us also. So, this is how legit it is. Makita niyo po dyan, may interview po for BFAR personnel. This is Ma'am G from BFAR. Makita niyo po dyan. Alright, so they are donating 1 million worth of facility na hatchery po. Hatchery meaning we will have a facility to hatch the eggs of bangus already. So we don't have to buy it from afar. So mangyayari po dyan, sa lugar na po natin, may hatchery na po. So bangus is being bred there. And then the organization has existing fish ponds na doon na natin palalakihin before natin ilagay sa dagat. So no more stress factor. Very clean production already. Wala na pong risk talaga actually. Maliit, napakaliit na lang po ng risk. Just watch this video so that you'll understand about it more. Magkano po minimum capital from Joseph Tanael? 6,500 po. Yun po yung pinaka. If you wanna start small, then you can do that. That is so wow, so interested, Sir Lloyd. So please check out the page po. Joseph Tanael, paano po deposit procedure? If ever, just go to the website and just add funds. The instructions are there. Okay, Rage Beta, join. Charlene Eden, join. Sir Lloyd, 1 year ba ang 20%? Right, just to be clear with you, yung first batches kasi, yung pilot project, right, we had, meron kaming promotion sa kanila na 20% po, lock po yun. But now, we cannot, for the future batches, we cannot promise you 20% talaga, right? It's between 10 to 20%. So, by average, mga 15% annually, that should be enough. Plus, if ever may loyalty, mas malaki makukuha ninyo. So, yan. Emma Oribiana, good morning, Sir Lloyd. Just tune in, MBT and Ali. We'll check that. Let's check that in a bit. You own this. This is from Arbitrage. Yes, a good friend. Check them out, guys. If you need help sa website, sa stock market ninyo, check out Arbitrage. Right, you own this, sir. Basically, it's owned by the association there. I'm just one of the managers. I'm just one of the head. I had the marketing and the finance department because ako po may alam paano maghawak ng pera. Yun po problema ng mga farmers natin. Yung mga farmers ng palay, even the fishermen, they lack financial literacy. So they don't know how to manage the funds. That's why I am there. Right? They don't know how to look for money, basically. That's why I'm there. Joy Rich, been watching you sa YouTube palang. So legit, thank you so much. Tommy Escobedo, coach, good morning. Pag hindi ko po kinuha ang pera ko dyan, continue lang po ba investment ko? Example, hanggang 5 years. Yes, every year, meron po kayong loyalty bonus. So, mas malaki po nakukuha ninyo compared to those nakakapasok lang and hindi po sila nag-continue. George, congrats for more investments. We'll deposit po. Kaso yung website visit ko, di ko pa masundan. Just check, just type in mangingisda.org. Alright, there may be glitches right now because we're doing updates sa website, but basically napakasimple lang po ng website. Rebecca Tangan, sir, hindi ko po ma-open. Hindi po ba mag-o-open lahat ng cages? We only have, as of the moment, we have 5 cages available. Okay? And then we have 2 coming this January, for January. ayoko po na lakihan kaagad ang project. Ayan, kasi baka magbigla doon. Ang biggest problem po kasi pag malakihan at magsabay-sabay mag-open is there is gonna be oversupply ng bangus. Oversupply means pag sabay-sabay mo kasi i-open ang lahat ng cage, sabay-sabay ang project, sabay-sabay ang harvest, ang dami pong isda available and it's gonna flood the market of bangus. Ang ending po niyan, mahirapan to tayo magbenta ng bangus kasi sobrang dami. And it's gonna make the bangus prices drop. So, malulugi po tayo. Right? So, it's not, hindi po feasible kasi na isabay-sabay sila. Siguro maximum natin is gonna be opening 3 to 4 cages every month. And then, para at least every month may harvest po tayo. So, that's the proper cycle there. Hindi po kasi pwede magsabay-sabay. Pwede po mag-roll ng capital from Rebecca Tangan. Yes, pwede po. We are adding the option of reinvesting your money once the mature na siya. Pwede niyo po i-reinvest so that it will automatically be placed on the next cages. And then meron po you are eligible for the loyalty bonus for the next harvest. And po, I mean, for the next maturity. So, mas malaki po makukuha ninyo. Emma Orbiana, magkano naman sir ang minimum investment dyan? For as low as 6,500. So, here is the projects ongoing. So, 6,500 po per unit. Diba? Per cage project is around 650,000. What we did is we divided that into 100 lots or unit. Right? So, 650,000 divided by 100, so that's 6,500. So pinakamaliit po ang 6,500 and it's up to you kahit po kumuha kayo ng isang buong cage pwede po. Actually, we have messages na isang buong cage ang kukunin nila. We just haven't catered to that yet because as much as possible, we make this available for the small investors. Kasi yung mga malaking investors na dyan. Alam ko, mas marami kasi opportunities pag malaki ang pera ninyo. But maliit po ang pera ninyo, lesser opportunities to invest. So here is one good investment opportunity for the small investors out there. That's why we're also doing this. Okay, so we're helping the fishermen and at the same time, we are helping the small-time investors. At least makapag-start small ang mga tao. Glenn Pagalan, sir, investor po ako ng Wave 1. After po ng harvest, ilang months po bago mag-reflect yung profit sa website. Alright, very good question, Grant Pagalan. So, I just wanna make this clear. 1 year po ang maturity period ng investment nyo. So, wave 1, right here, what you're seeing in the key right now, hindi po ibig sabihin ng wave 1, isang harvest po yan. Wave 1, so ito yung unang cage na inopen natin. But this is, your money is good for 1 year. Ang isang harvest po kasi will take around 6 months, right? So, basically, in 1 year, there will be 2 harvests. So, mag-harvest pa tayo ulit. Then after that, after maturity, dyan nyo po makukuha ang investment ninyo. So, we open it as June. So, most probably, June po makukuha ninyo ang pera ninyo. So, 2 harvests po yan. Ang ginawa po namin. Kasi, for the first harvest, we wanna secure the investors first. Sabi ko sa mga mangingisda, hati-hati lang muna tayo sa sweldo, wala munang profits, unahin natin investor. So, this first, yung unang mga harvest, that is to secure the gains of the investors. And then, yung second harvest, yung gains naman ng mga mangingisda ang isi-secure namin. Just so that we can protect the investors. So, okay naman ang mangingisda as long as may sweldo naman sila. Right? May sweldo po kasi sila dito for feeding the fishes. And then, ang profits, later na lang sa second harvest na ang para sa kanila. So, that's okay with them. I am daw, ako na po bahala magpaintindi sa kanila about patience and about thinking long term kasi short term mag-isip ang mga ano short term mag-isip ang mga kapatid natin mga mangisda especially yung nasa probinsya po. Right. So ako na po bahala mag-seminar sa kanila. Robert Pelais, sir, na late po ako, ilang months po bago mag-harvest? 6 months ang harvest pero ang for harvesting your investment 1 year po ang holding period. So, dalawang harvest po yan. So, it should reflect, makikita niyo po dyan sa June na may tubo na po yung pera ninyo. So, what you do is, makikita niyo po dito sa dashboard niyo anong current waves invested kayo, and then kailan ang maturity, and then magkano po yung amount. So, example, you put in 6,500, and then ang tubo is 20%, so that's around 1,200, etc. So, yung amount po dito is magiging from 6,500, magiging 7,700, right? May status po dito na completed. So click, you just click on complete, and then you can makikita niyo po ang details ng investment, and then you can mapupunta po yan dito, and then you can withdraw it anytime. Okay. How does it work po? Hestia Tunyakaw. So medyo ipit na tayo sa time. It's already 9:24 na pa at haba yung usapan natin. Again, for the stock market, by noon, magpo-post ba ako ng ano magandang bibilhin for the end of the year, because we're expecting the market to rally today. So we're gonna wait for bounces at the early part, and then lagyan po natin ng pera after this afternoon. Okay, so please go to the webs for the page, and then sa pinakaunang video po, because you how does it work, meron po tayong walkthrough video on how the process really works, right? Hindi ko na po ma-discuss dito. So this video right here, pinakamataas, ito yung video niya. Click on this link right here. Ito, here is a link of the walkthrough video to help on how the purchase process works, how to purchase the units, the lots, meaning it's a chunk of the fishes available. Andyan po sa link na ito. So just click on this link right here. So you will be forwarded to the walkthrough video. Okay, so Glenn Pagalan, understood sir. Thank you so much. More power, and thank you po for this opportunity. Thank you din so much. Basically, if you just know how happy the fishermen of Mindanao are because of this. Makita niyo lang po yung mga videos pag harvest nila. Sus. Ang mga mata nila nagkakaching na. Pero sabi ko sa nila, patience lang muna, yung unang harvest hindi puro para sa atin, unang harvest para sa mga investors. So ayan po. Anyways, masaya pa rin sila because at least monthly may kinikita sila, kasi part of the cost is yung sweldo rin kasi nila. So at least napapasweldohan natin sila, and then profits when the second harvest comes. Okay, so like the page, follow the page, mangisda.org. Alright. And also, don't forget to like my page na rin, Financial Freedom 101, for more opportunities like this in the future. I always feature investments for you guys. I look for the best investment para po sa inyo. Joy Rich, pero yung calculation po ba ng kita will be equal po ba? Like for example, mas malaki ang kita ng second harvest, just asking po, pero nothing against it. Kahit mas malaki mapunta sa fishermen po. Don't worry, it will be on average. So, kasi, minsan kasi, ang linalagay natin na ano, linalagay po natin na fishes sa isang cage is around 16,000. Ito na pala, nakuha ko na ang tanong kanina, ano ba yung risk percentage? Meron po kasi mortality rate dito. Namamatayan po tayo during production. So, like for example, itong harvest na nangyari kahapon is around 14,000 fishes lang. So, meaning we were projecting 15,000. 15,000 is the healthiest. And then, namatayan po tayo, may mga 1,000 po ang nakuwala. So, we still have 14,000. And then, for the second harvest, average lang po natin yan. 15,000, kung perfect po natin na 15,000, 20% po ang mabibigay natin, di ba? So, if ever yung average natin is around 14,000, so much lesser ang percentage makukuha natin. But still, that's still very good profits, I tell you. Still above, ang projection po sa natin is, if ever, ang average natin is at 10,000 pesos, meaning, 10,000 fishes, meaning namatay ang 5,000, we can still arrive at around 10 to 12%. So, andun pa rin po tayo. Depende rin kasi sa presyo ng isda during that time. So, it's still feasible that way. Kahit po kalahati ang mamatay, may kita pa rin po tayo. But, doesn't happen. Right? So, yun po. It's already 9:30. Siguro I won't be able to discuss about stock market as of the moment, but isa lang po ang didiscuss ko sa inyo guys. If you're looking for a bigger avenue to invest in, check out eToro, right? I trade in eToro. Pwede niyo po akong kopyahin. We are already up 2.65% for December. Yung mga nabenta ko, nagsisisi ako kasi tumaas pa ng tumaas sila Microsoft. But that's okay. What I wanted to do is really take profits. You're already up 10.82% for this year. Congratulations sa mga kumopya sa akin noon nang nagsimula tayo. But anyways, I'm not advertising for you to copy me. Ang ina-advertise ko po is other traders out there. There are very low risk traders out there, medium risk score but 85%, right? Kung gusto nyo po talaga ng malaki yan, you want a high risk high reward investment for your extra cash talaga, then this is good for you, right? 85%, 56%. Check out these people. Make sure you check out their performance, right? For this guy Adamski, bago lang ito si Adamski, laki ng returns niya. But this guy's doing good for 1 year and po siya. So ganda ng performance niya. Meron nang nagka-copy sa kanya na 200. So check out his statistics, right? He is 103% for this year even, right? Na minus pala yung December niya last year. But if you started copying him January, laki na ng kita ninyo, 103%. So look for these people, copy people, and then yan, most copied meaning ito yung mga kinokopya, maraming nagkokopya. So you look for people who will trade for you for passive income. Sila na po magte-trade sa inyo through eToro, right? Hiling ko lang po sa inyo, in return, please create an eToro account using my link. Andyan po sa video description, meron pong link dyan for creating an eToro account. So very good, napakaganda po na international market. Look at this DJ 30 reached another peak last night. Ang dami mga companies. Ito mga watchlist, nagka-copy lang sa akin naman ito. But ang dami po notifications, ang ganda ng stock market sa US kagabi. Nag-all-time high na naman sila, Apple, etc. So sobrang dami po market. So it's really nice to trade in the international market. If you want to join us in trading in the international market instead, sa PSE, please, investing lang po kayo dyan. Mahirap po mag-trade dyan. Mas marami po opportunity sa international market because of short selling. So, kahit pabaga sa... Ngayon, actually, I'm expecting the market to really do a pullback kasi sobrang taas na ng US market. So, I'm looking to short the positions kung may shorting signals tayo. So, even if pababa ang market, pwede po tayong kumita sa international market. That's why it's good to trade there. Okay? Again, please create an eToro account using my link. Tomorrow, it's a Saturday. Next week, I'll see you again next week. Kamustahin natin ang mga investments natin for next week. So, next week, since konti lang ang market, we're gonna look for more investments for you. We're gonna be discussing more investments. If you have any requests na pwede natin i-cover for your other investments, I'm looking to cover CDN and farm on .ph next week. So, check that out po. Abangan nyo po, right? Post it on the comments if ever may gusto kayong investment na ipa-review sa atin. So, titignan po natin. Right, that's it for this week. That's it for today. It's a Friday. Guys, kung may nakita na kayo na magandang pasukin sa market today, since napakamura na and it's a good company, bilhin nyo na po. I'm expecting for the market to rally. PSEI is already open. Let's see how PSEI opened. Right, so we're already starting with a green already for PSEI. So as I was expecting it to go green today, I'm even expecting for it to do a breakout for today, si PSEI. So yeah, hanap na kayo ng pwede niyong pasukin, especially the good companies na mura pa. Right, you do bargain hunt already for the morning. Right, I'll see you again next week. Please expect my post this noon para po sa ano magandang bilhin at the end of the market day. Enjoy your weekend and as always, let's get rich together. Bye everyone. Thank you po. Please follow my page and like.